All right, we'll go ahead and get started with questions for JT. Please raise your hand if you have a question.
Mike,
we'll start right here with Austin.
JT, what's going through your mind on that play in double overtime when Curtis gets the ball and then it seems like all hell breaks loose?
Man, I was trying to block somebody, but I ain't the best blocker. I tried to block, but I think he went back like 3 times. So I'm glad he's really good because everybody was trying to get a piece of somebody, but he just made everybody miss.
Is that a busted play? What would you guys call that?
Nah, I think that was just a good job on their part. It was a screen, and number 5 came over the top. He scraped over the top. I guess he had Curtis in man. I thought we had a good look. That's why we ran the play, or that's why I continued to run the play. Then he made a good job scraping over the top, and then Curtis did his thing.
Right down here in front, Tim.
Yeah, JT. Offense was almost non-existent at times today, and all of a sudden, fourth quarter, you guys came alive, and of course, overtime. What just came right for you guys? What did y'all finally get going? And then number 2, what's going through your head right now? You win a double overtime game against Michigan. You're alive big time in the college football playoff ranking.
I think the first half, we had good things called. We just weren't executing, whether it be myself, O-line receivers. It was everybody played their part in that. And then in the second half, I mean, it was defense doing their job. We got to do ours. So let's go out there and do our part. And they were doing everything that we prepared for. So it was just really going out there and execute that. And then right now, been a part of some crazy football games here. That one's number 1. I'm just really thankful, honestly. Grateful for the, as God has blessed me with all these blessings. Happy for our fans, I think Buckeye Nation, to have that game played at home. Just happy that we was able to go out there and win for the seniors and win for Buckeye Nation.
Right over here, Bill.
JT, 2 years ago you were not able to finish the game. How much did it mean to you to lead the team to victory? And also on the fourth down play, can you walk us through that play? How sure were you that you got that first down?
I guess I didn't really think about me being injured last time we played at home against Tewa North. I think it was one of the things, you know, you learn and grow from as part of the game. And then, honestly, when I got hit, I wasn't 100% certain, to be honest with you. I looked at it, but where I fell on top of, like, people, so I just didn't know exactly where I was going to be. But I'm glad we got it. Review said it was good.
Ari, right here in the left. JT, in the fourth quarter and in overtime, you guys were in situations where you had fourth and short, you could have tied it, and Coach Meyer decided to go for it in very critical situations. That was basically the game. What's it like being a quarterback in that situation, getting the confidence from the coach to go for it, and how stressful or maybe even terrifying is it for you guys in those situations?
I don't like your word choice, terrifying, stressful. No, that's what we do. When he says, honestly, we went fourth and short, I feel like we can go for it every time. Like, I know field position plays a part of it, but if we're on our side of the 50 or on their side of the 50, I'm really jacked about it. Like, let's go do that because that's what we do. We are in those situations countless of times before the season starts and spring ball. And then when it comes to the season, that's what we do. We take risks. And we have a great offensive line to go out there and go get those first downs. So, terrified, stressed is not the words I use.
And a few weeks ago, you were pretty outspoken about this team in the college football playoff conversation. Now that you guys have done everything that you can, where do you think this team stands if you guys don't make it to the Big Ten championship?
I remember what I said. It's really out of our hands at this time. I think we are one of the top 4 teams in the country, personally. But I think that, like I said, it's up to the committee to do their thing. Hopefully everything works out in our favor. So,
right down here in front, Steve.
JT, when you got through that whole melee and got into the locker room with your guys, just talk about what that moment was like when you guys were able to get together and realize what you just accomplished. 5 straight, I guess, over Michigan, and for you guys that are here now, and just with all the former players that were here today and everything else that was kind of rolled into it.
Right. I don't know. I guess I didn't do a lot of thinking, honestly. I was just looking around like, man, that just happened. Like, we just played Tewa North, and it was double overtime, and we just won. So, I don't know. It's, I think that's why you, you know, play the game of football for moments like this, because, you know, all the training we go through, all the workouts and yelling, screaming. I mean, this is why you play the game for moments like this against your rivals in a great atmosphere for college football and for your teammates. And I think that was just something we shared right there, that, you know, we let our seniors go out with a bang. Those guys got 5 gold pants. 5. Some people don't even get 1, but the fact that they got 5, that's truly a blessing, and I was just very thankful that I could be a part of this.
Got time for one more on the left here, Obi.
Still football fever. Hey, JT, give us a little sneak peek of the conversation with you and Tyler Durbin. Some of the things that maybe you spoke to him to kind of calm him down.
I just told him that he got this. I mean, when I think about it, there's times I miss passes and there's times he missed field goals. Like, that's our jobs, that's our roles. I'm supposed to complete passes, he's supposed to kick field goals, and I'm supposed to go in. That's really clear, you know, so when it doesn't happen, it's almost like then or the world, but it's okay. Just understand that that's part of it. Just be in the moment right now, just forget about the pass. I mean, that's something that I tried to do in the first half. Did I play great? Absolutely not. But the simple fact is that that's in the past, and we got to play on and move forward. And I think that was something that I was trying to express to him, that it's okay. That, you know, we believe in you. You go out there and you put it right through the pipes like you always told us. So it's all good.
JT, thank you. Coach is here, ready to go.